And you can see on the right side, in the middle, we have the picture of the STM32, which is the microcontroller which we wanted. You can see STM32F401RE and LQFP64. And you can see also the available pins. The pins, okay, there are maybe some yellow pins. You can click on them, but you cannot change these pins. They are usually fixed for the specific purpose. Usually the yellow ones are the power pins. These pins must be always connected and always decoupled. Be careful, never left microcontroller pin without decoupling. But they are also the second pins, which are not yellow. They are usually yellow-gray. They have also some specific purpose, and these pins must be also connected. The one of these pins is usually reset. For these pins, we recommend at least decoupling capacitor to increase the robustness against the external noise. And the second pin, which is here on this STM32, is the boot pin. This boot pin defines the behavior of the microcontroller during the startup. If you left this pin unconnected, the behavior can be unpredicted. One time you can start from your internal flash, second time you can start from the internal bootloader. For this pin must be always connected to the ground or to the VDD. The details you can find in the datasheet and in the reference manual. Then if these pins are marked here in the QPMX as the yellow or as the gray yellow, please, these pins must be always connected, and please check the connection. Okay, this was the right side when you see your pinout. The rest gray pins can be selected for your application as you want. You can see if I click on this pin, I get the menu when I can assign the functionality. All pins, gray pins, can be set as the inputs, as the output, or into the analog mode, or they share some alternate function which cooperate with internal IPs like the USARTs. You can see here the example. PA10 can be set, for example, as the USART 1 receive pin. But this will take a long time. Then if you want to see the other IPs which we have, they are on the left side in the peripheral part. They are all peripherals which are inside this STM32. You can see there is a lot of them. And on the top part are the middleware packages which you can also activate it. For example, the file system, VR2S, and USB stacks. But if they are gray, it means that you need to activate the peripheral first before you can select the middleware package. If you point the mouse on the gray part, then usually QPMX trying to tell you what is wrong. You can see here he advises you to enable the USB IP. Okay, the IPs. Usually, if the IP is, for example, green, this means that the peripheral is active. For example, I here activate the SPI. You can see it's green, it's full active in this mode, no problems. But there can be some conflicts, like here. You can see there is the yellow explanation mark. And what this means? This means that I cannot, for example, activate these features like the channels for the ADC because they are occupied with the SPI, which I selected now. And then can be second alert, which is red. This means I cannot use this functionality at all because something occupied the same functionality. I will try it here. Sorry. I will here enable the user at one in the asynchronous mode. And you can see I cannot set now the USB on the go in the dual role because one of the functionalities which I need to use are occupied with the user at one. And if I here select the more pins, you can see I cannot use the USB at all. But the CubeMX trying to tell you what is wrong, where is the conflict. You can see there is the problem that I select the USART1 in the asynchronous mode. And also I select the PA11 in the GPIO output mode. If I disable these functionalities, I can again, I can select, for example, the USB.